everyone. My name is Peter Melamed. I'm a holistic practitioner of Biotherapy Alternative Medicine Clinic in San Francisco. And today's topic, it's very serious. We will talk about the biliary dyskinesia or low functioning of the gallbladder. So the cut gallbladder or don't cut it. So the many people, even small one, kids, children, they have periodically pain in the upper part of the stomach, mostly in the right side. Usually it can be gas, bloating, nausea. And this attack usually can be after eating of fatty and the sugary food or drinking alcohol. So no question, this serious problem, and the parents or young adults, okay, they will go to doctor or go to emergency room. So after treatment with something, the painkillers or some another things, so the pain go away. And the what next? What we have to do next? The doctor do some lab test. This usually the lab test, usually blood test or visual test, like ultrasound. So this test came negative. So the doctor presume condition, what is called biliary dyskinesia. What does it mean, biliary? Biliary mean the bile. Dys mean not proper. And kinesia, moving. So the not proper movement in the biliary tract. This is biliary tract, it including not only the gallbladder. They including the gallbladder, they including the bile duct and sphincter of Oddi. So the the doctor call this condition by different kind of name. Let me read it. It's called the sphincter of Oddi dysfunction type 3, acalculosis cholecystopathy, acalculosis biliary disease, chronic calculosis cholecystitis. Acalculosis mean the no gallbladder stones. So I take this name from medical literature. It shows that even between specialists, we don't have a consensus, we don't have the real name of this situation, and we don't have real treatment of the situation. Because we live in pharmaceutical world. The pharmaceutical cannot improve functioning of the gallbladder. The pharmaceutical can do only symptomatic treatment. So we live in pharmaceutical and surgical world, so the doctor usually send a person to surgeon. Surgeon can make the different kind of test. One of the tests, it's a visual test. They can show the gallbladder ejection, so gallbladder contraction. So this test need a test. I don't go deeply in detail, but if the contraction of the gallbladder less than 35-40, this is a like death sentence for gallbladder, and doctors say, no, your gallbladder doesn't work, you don't need it, so we can do the gallbladder removal, or the medical term cholecystectomy. So the question arises, what we have to do? If you will go to surgeon, the answer will be only one. Remove the gallbladder. So remove the gallbladder or not remove the gallbladder in case of biliary dyskinesia. Our answer is no. And this is not only our opinion. The many medical doctors or even surgeon in the United States also consider that we don't need to remove the gallbladder in case of biliary dyskinesia. So, to translate this medical terminology to everyday conversation, we can say the medical doctors in the United States, and this is the articles was published by doctors from the Division of Gastroenterology, University of Pittsburgh, Medical Center Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh, USA. So this is the doctor, what the doctors mean. The doctors mean, number one, the amount of the gallbladder removal surgeries go rise very, very, very much. And more for account of the young population, the kids, children, and young adults. So seven times more operation for the last 10 years. So if you put an account 750,000 gallbladder removal in the United States per year, and the 10% of it, the young adults and kids, children, this is will be 75,000 the kids. So this is a very serious concern, because this serious concern. And I will talk about this later. Next articles, it's called Cholecystectomy for Biliary Dyskinesia. How did we get there? So what does it mean to translate it in everyday conversation? The doctors consider that the visual test, especially the test for contraction and injection of the gallbladder, it's not 100% right. So we have a medical articles who show this is a this test, number one, a lot of false positive result. So in one article it was a 27% of positive result. So does it mean? It means that some patient lose the gallbladder for nothing. So secondary, we have a lot of articles which show that in the result of this test influenced by many medication. So this medication, especially the hormones, especially women hormones, birth control pills, painkillers, the medication who decrease the acidity in the stomach, they can make a false positive result. People would have obesity, have diabetes, taking birth control pills, pregnant ladies, they can have a false positive result of this injection gallbladder result. So, and secondary, they would from this conclusion. So this is a functional diseases. Functional, it's mean that we don't have structural problem in this gallbladder. So we can do something to make this functional, decrease this dysfunctional these organs and make it moving properly. So next, what I can be concerned. This is another articles by medical doctor from Europe. So this medical doctor, and another one, this is a doctor from Europe, from Hanover. For Hanover, this is West Germany. So they published the articles, it's called Post-Cholecystectomy Syndrome with Special Regards of to Children, review. What does it mean, post-cholecystectomy syndrome? So this is these authors and many authors from United States consider the post-cholecystectomy syndrome, this is a strike, the people after removing the gallbladder, 15, 30, 33%. So when you go to the doctor and surgeon, and we ask doctor if I will remove my gallbladder, so my pain will be gone. The doctor will say yes, it will be not exactly correct, because by medical statistic, 14-33% of person without gallbladder, they continue to have the pain. Plus, we have a lot of problem with the indigestion, because the gallbladder, and when you see my previous presentation, you will know the gallbladder, this is a very important organ. It's not the mother nature doesn't make a mistake. So it's very important organ for us. So without gallbladder, digestion is compromised. So the people after gallbladder removal, they have a post-cholecystectomy syndrome. It means gas beside the pain, gas, bloating, stubborn heartburn. It means the bile reflex, and they have a constipation, or we have the bile acids diarrhea. Very difficult to treat situation. So this statistic not include the very important things like symptoms what is very far from stomach. So the people have a depression, anxiety, sort of like irritable bowel syndrome, sensitivity to pain, not good sleep. It connected with deficiency of vital nutrients. But because without gallbladder, our digestive system not work properly. So if you will go to the doctor referral from surgeon, the surgeon, this is a the brilliant technique, wonderful, very prepared medical doctors, but they prepared for surgery. They don't prepare to how to treat it conservatively, how to treat it with another way to help the gallbladder to function properly. So removing gallbladder and getting the one of the more common operation in the United States. So yes, they will tell you this is if you hole, the cosmetically almost won't see it. This is like ambulatory operation, so you can go home in the evening or in the next day. Everything will be okay. But again, I repeat, almost one third. But I think it will be just tip of the iceberg. It can be maybe one half people without gallbladder. Anyway, they will be struck by post-cholecystectomy syndrome. So the what we quote from doctors, this is a doctor from published in American in the journal, medical journal Digestion. This is a name, title of this name, gallbladder dysfunction, how much longer will be controversial. This is American doctor what they write about the gallbladder dysfunction. Another review, it's Cochrane review. I have to understand the Cochrane review. This is the most respectful the review in medical world about the different kind of field of medicine. So review in the Cochrane review, this is usually the opinion, right opinion of the medical medical opinion. So the Cochrane review was published in 2009 to study efficiency of cholecystectomy conducted. So what does it mean? It means again, this is the removing the gallbladder. It's not really scientifically proved. This is only the last 10 years you have an epidemic of gallbladder removal. And this is we need the time to assess how it will be in the long run, in the lifetime, how it influences in our body, in functioning of our body, even not just digestive tract, the whole our body. I graduated from medical school 50 years. Maybe 40 years I treat the people with a problem with gallbladder problem and the biliary tract problems. So it was at 15 years an intensive care doctor, anesthesiologist, and then an outpatient setting. So I know the post-cholecystectomy syndrome. I know what is biliary dyskinesia. I treat the many people, and I will talk about the treatment my next presentation. But if you think I have to be to take your attention about the parents. So we live in a situation the problem with gallbladder getting younger. So we have a, even with younger younger, even children, we have a problem with gallbladder. It depends on many very important things. This is obesity, the weight issue is very important. Our diet, it's not healthy for gallbladder system. The using the birth control pills in teenagers, early pregnancy, a lot of medication. So this is make the problem with biliary dyskinesia younger. So the even the small kid can cause a mommy have a pain or crying and show they have a pain in the stomach. So for parents, I work with kids all my life. The kids, it's great performers. So the in kids, very good psychologist. You cannot imagine. They wanna number one. They like to play the doctor patient game. They like to take attention, papa, mama, to the father and mother, to them. So they even have pain in the stomach, and the mama, papa, they didn't put him in the school or kindergarten. The kids, they fix it in their mind. So if the mama especially make a wrong question, do you have a pain in your tummy? So the kid, voluntary or involuntary, they will play this game. So what is my advice? We have to be very carefully estimate the situation with kids, and good specialist can make a diagnosis, it's a real problem or it's the kids or kid, this is in kids' mind, number one. Number two, we don't need to be in a hurry to remove the gallbladder. I know it's easy to take the pills, I know it's easy to take the surgery instead of to change the lifestyle, to do something, the active life, or make a changes in the life. But anyway, this is your kids, your children, and their health and future, it's very important stuff for you. So, bottom line of this situation, again, I repeat, we don't need to be in a hurry to remove gallbladder, especially in the young one.